Here's chapter 3, Ominous Men. I sort of already did think he was mean. I meant the newspaper's message from him. I don't have any idea why it wasn't BOAP or on the newspaper. He's way nicer than Volcavo. I slept in my bed for a while. I awoke around 6:55. Yeah, it was early. I had to catch 3 more hours of sleep, so I did that. This spooked me. May I like your answer, Mr. Gorgo? Mr. Wrote. Rhodes. I was in a tube with a see-through plastic. Darn it. The pool killer has awoken once again. Need to give it to sleep so we can take blood. Give the med to it, please, Miss Savargo, a casual voice had said. My vision started to be clear. In other glass wall was 6 feet in front of me. A man and a woman were to the glass. I started crying. I do not want to go to sleep, I screamed harshly. I love when they talk like they make barking seal noises, the woman said in glory. I nodded no. Do not kill me, please. I want to live, not die. Never would I want to die. They both laughed. I looked at a sign, frantically. USC departments, to keep you safe. No way. No way. This is what Mom does? That is cruel. Devilish. I was growing by the second with anger and fear. Mom kills unknowns. She will regret that. No, don't kill me. She's a true demon. They're gonna kill. A needle got injected into my right arm. I jumped and hit the back of my head on the left side of the tube. I cracked my head towards them. They were shocked. Kill him, they both said. Tears were automatically going down my cheeks. No, never, I yelled back. He's the cursed one, the man screamed in fear. The woman said, or started. I was hyperventilating. Now, said the voice from the beginning, your actual answer, you will die and the species will go extinct. Most likely. Why? Why though? I asked. No idea. They're learning more every moment. Even right now, it said. I will let you go. Before you leave, it yelled back. Grasp this information very specially, please. Do not forget me in this information I have given you. Okay, I said. I will do so. Okay, it said. Goodbye. I looked over to my clock. 9:19 a.m. Okay, not the best, but okay. My nervous system was advanced because of the nightmare. I felt as if I was having a seizure. My limbs were twitching, my skin felt dry. My stomach was quaking, my brain was racing, my gills had gone no more, my teeth were chattering, my blood went faster. No. All of a sudden, it all stopped. My legs were flung to my chest, and my arms wrapped around it. I was terrified. I had no power in my tail. Help! I screeched horribly. A bunch of men caught my eye. Will you please help me? I yelled. Most of the men gave me a grim grin. Others ignored me fully. Never, a man said. I recognized the voice. It was the one from my nightmare. Are you? I screamed. You do not complain to my leader, you rat, said the same voice. Come out of that house right now. Cannot. Why, demon? Give me an answer. I am, I said. I cannot if you enter demon. What a flipping answer right now. Yes, of course. Well, I replied. Well, what? Do not interrupt. My body unwrapped itself. Yeah. I started. What? Charge! A different voice yelled at the top of his lungs. Everybody had an axe and slammed down my door. There! This might be a really big mood change, but what is your names, please? I asked. I, someone stepped out, am Zorlox, or the dead. Exactly. Lorcave, Kato, Koei, Toteter, Coxo, Vorse, Zoss. Counting Zoss and Kato stooped more out. Zoss swiped his axe at me. Zoss fell to his left from the weight of the axe. Vorse full out lunged at me. He fell in front of me. I know how to attack. I flipped over Vorse. I slid towards exactly and got his shirt. I flung him towards the right side. I looked to my left to see men with raised axes. I pulled out a blade. I kicked the part of his handle. The blade flung to his chin. Critical hit. Ripped open chin achieved. Koei ran at me. I backed away. Same thing happened with him, but he fell on the blade. Three more. I surrender. I swear. Lockave and Kato scream. I stared at Totator. He was frozen in fear. I surrender, he said. In order to, I yelled, leave this house. Okay, they all said. They ran into each other, getting out the door. They had been filled to the brim with fear. They were afraid. I ran in the building frantically. I was greeted by Slaycore. I need to see BWAP, I said. Okay, Slaycore replied. Thank you so much, I said. You're welcome, Slaycore said. No, you, I said, swimming down the hall very fast. I sprinted up the stairs. BWAP, I yelled. BWAP was nowhere seen in his office. BWAP. That's that done. The next one is, I need a stretch. The next one is The Missing Man. Be seeing something right now. I messed it up. But it's fine anyways. Bye.